in my bailiwick. So I mean, if I know there's a lot of competent people on the two the commissions and the committee that put this together, as well as town council, so my hat's off to them. The only comment I would make, and this is more for posterity because I do not think it will affect any of us in the room, but under some cases, under Massachusetts general law, these restrictions, deed restrictions, have a 30-year sunset clause. I don't know if that applies here, but at some point, you know, obviously I don't think I'll be around 30 years. But it may run out.
It's a good point.
Yeah, it's a good question. I'll find out.
There may be different shades of that as well.
You can renew it.
Yeah.
At the time, it just needs to be done properly, and it may not apply to this. I don't know. I just know that's a general.
Thank you for bringing that up.
I guess we'll cross that bridge. Well, we should know the bridge is there.
You'll be backing.
Me? I don't think I'm going to smell too good in 30 years.
I know that for affordable housing, a 30-year term limit, if you will, was quite common, and then that became allowed to be in perpetuity. So I don't know how that applies to the deed restrictions.
Yeah, that's right. When we went through the affordable housing discussion, there were a few units still subject to that 30-year window, and then it had gone away in favor of forever.
Yeah, I don't know. I'll send you the
that's a good question.
General law question, Bob, and you can do with it what you will.
Okay.
Yeah, and just to give color to the board, we didn't really get into as much of a discussion last week as I thought we might, but the two historical groups and the criterion were sort of the first round negotiations, and there were some pretty big differences, but they came to an agreement. They all actually did a very nice job, and then we're a little bit surprised that Mass Historic stepped in and kind of gave them a little bit of a side swipe. So it seemed unusual in those groups' experience that they would all agree and someone else would say no.
Right.
And Ray did a good job to sort of corral them all in, and that's. So to the extent this has taken a long time, again, it's been more complex than someone would have imagined at the beginning.
And this is actually a tri-party agreement, so it's harder to get three people to agree, obviously, than two. So.
Right.
I just want, I want to give kudos to Historic District Commission for, I think, working in the midst of what was a very controversial issue, fairly weighing the interests of both sides, the residents that had concerns, and petitioner, and then coming up with a very solid set of conditions under which this project can go forward. So I think they did an outstanding job on that.
It took a long time, but
it did.
The fact that we've ended up here is powerful. It's taken a long time to get here, but all's well and ends well.
Yeah. Right. I might, this document then also ends the need, in my estimation, for us to leave some old executive session minutes silent.
Okay. So those can be open.
So those, I will release those as my authority.
Right.
And I just want to mention, as the community gets to read those minutes, kudos to the prior Board of Selectmen, whoever was there, I don't remember. But there was a lot of time and effort put into this issue on behalf of the residents of Summer Adams.
Oh, yeah.
A serious issue. The selectmen went all the way from possibly buying the property to having a lot of negotiations.
We couldn't talk about any of this stuff.
And we couldn't talk about any of that, but now we can, because now, as of this incident, the executive session minutes will be released.
Yeah. I think we actually had a negotiator meeting with a couple of the residents there.
Yeah, well, it turned out.
It's obviously a very challenging issue.
Yeah. Yeah,
so,
discussion. Sorry.
Yeah, I just to make sure I get the main thrust of the document, and also for the benefit of people listening, the restriction is that they keep the two buildings in place. They don't move the two buildings, and they keep the outside of the buildings.
The outside is what
sort of they maintain the outside of
that's
the buildings in the.
It's in their bailiwick.
Right. And right, and then the stuff inside does not fall under this restriction.
Correct.
Is that
right.
Sound like a fair summary?
You got it.
And it's a good point you raise. A resident came to see me between your last two meetings or this one and asked if any of the plans had changed. He saw the issue. He was specifically concerned about drainage. I said, no, this is all, if you will, lawyers and future rights to oversee a property. The actual plan as described have not changed a bit. Contractor may do hopefully matches what the plans are. The plans were negotiated and finalized long ago.
Any other comments? If not, all those in favor of the motion, please raise your hand. 3-0. Is there any other business to come before the board? If not, I'll entertain a motion to adjourn.
I'll make a motion to adjourn.
Second.
We have a second. All those in favor of adjournment? 3-0 at 7:18.
Is that a personal best?
That's our.
Good night, everybody.
It's got to be a record. Good night.
Good night, Mrs. Calabash, wherever you are.